Well, as Australia suffers through its worst bushfire season in decades, there's renewed interest in Indigenous fire prevention strategies. But how are they different?
More than 10 million hectares burnt, at least 28 lives lost. Our nation has been hit hard and it's not over yet.
Well, our elders always told us that fire is a good servant but a bad master. If he gets control, he's a monster.
Uncle Cole, like many Indigenous people, believes bushfires would be less intense if traditional prevention techniques were used.
Aboriginal people, we're not really recognised in things like this. We want to be part of that, be involved together, which we haven't been.
Cultural or cool burning predates colonisation by around 40,000 years. It's still practised across Australia, mainly in the Northern Territory, but because of current fire policies and the need for permits, cultural burners can only access certain areas. It involves setting alight undergrowth in the bush during the cooler months, so flammable debris, which could act as fuel for future fires, is destroyed. Flames are never intended to reach more than half a metre high, so that trees can remain untouched and animals can take refuge. A normal burn-off these days consists of a large, widespread fire that's started and managed by authorities. Dr. Christine Finlay is an expert in bushfire behaviour.
From the 1920s, when fuel loads started to mount due to government policy change, which discouraged cool burning, firestorms started to emerge as problems. They've become worse and worse and more ever since.
Dr. Finlay says over the past few years, she's been urging politicians to make cultural burning a priority.
I've been totally ignored. The responses have varied from people being very belligerent, screaming at me and hanging up, to just politely giving me the brush off.
The Rural Fire Service says it has crews trained in cultural burning and believes it plays a meaningful role. But it can be labour-intensive and therefore expensive. Whatever the case, Indigenous elders want it on the agenda at any bushfire royal commission.
I spent some time with an Indigenous guide in WA, Margaret River, last year, and he was pointing at the bush and saying, look, that would never look like that if we followed the practices of our people and we always did these cool burns. I mean, the problem is that we've got shorter times to do it.
Yeah. And it's cost more.
But we had to be consulting with the Indigenous. I think we grew up thinking that when the English came here, the Indigenous were just here, like, catching their food. But they were cultivating the land. They were...